The bull you are looking at right now is by Italian sculptor Arturo de Modica, but it's not in New York City at Bowling Green. This is the bull that Arturo created for Shanghai to stand in front of their stock exchange. You don't see any barricades. You don't see any police car. It is wide open to be enjoyed by visitors and for the Chinese. China, which is officially called a police state. It's in dramatic contrast to what is going on now at Bowling Green, at the foot of Broadway, the most famous of Arturo de Modica's bulls, Charging Bull, which has stood here at Bowling Green since December 20th, 1989. For 22 years, up until last September 17th, 2011, the bull, a Charging Bull, since 1989, had been free, out in the open, available and accessible to New Yorkers and visitors from around the world. Then, on September 17th of last year, and up until the very moment that I'm making this recording on March the 14th, 2012, for 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, Charging Bull has been caged with a police car constantly parked in front of it. It has destroyed the dramatic appeal that this bull had had, the unique attraction had become in the entire history of our city is being destroyed by, of all people, our police commissioner and the New York City Police Department for no justifiable reason. You're watching footage from last Saturday, March the 10th, as visitors still come, as they do, in far fewer numbers than they did before, but still come because they want to see the bull, they want to get up close with Arturo de Modica's Charging Bull. But as you can see, on this particular day, they could not do that at all. Some days, the police officers on duty will make a small opening in the barricades and let people line up and go in one by one as though they're going to jail for a visit to see the bull. This particular Saturday, they didn't feel like opening up the barricades. They just had the bull completely barricaded, as you see here, and people had no choice but to stand out in the street to try to get some kind of picture with the bull. And who's paying for this? We're paying for this. The taxpayers of New York are paying for this. You see the figures in front of you, my estimate of how much it is causing us, how much it is costing us for what is going on at Bowling Green. In a city short of funds for many good and necessary uses, we are spending hundreds of thousands of dollars on police overtime for no good reason. Take a look at these scenes. Let it sink in what is going on here. Stay with the video because as you watch more and more of this footage, you get the true sense of how absurd, how ridiculous, how unfortunate, how counterproductive this is. And again, this is not a short-term problem. This week, on March 17th, will be 6-month anniversary of this nonsense taking place in our city. One of its most famous attractions, a icon, with such appeal that virtually every visitor to the city and many New Yorkers would always come to visit the bull. This is not the scene that took place at Bowling Green for almost 22 years, but this is the scene at Bowling Green since September 17th of last year. Look at what we also have. The New York City Police Department creating this dangerous situation. Cars, trucks, buses passing as individuals are forced to stand in the street to try and get somewhat near the bull. This is ridiculous. It's an outrage. Now contrast the current scene at Bowling Green to the way it was for 22 years up until last September 17th. The difference is dramatic. What you're seeing now is photos of scenes that happened year-round, 365 days a year, for 22 years since the arrival of Arturo Demodica's charging bull here, December 20th, 1989. This joyous scene, why this place was so famous, had such tremendous appeal, the magnetic attraction that Charging Bull had always been at Bowling Green, until Police Commissioner Ray Kelly made a decision to destroy that appeal by creating this obnoxious, horrible cage. Look at this kid up there. This is a quintessential example of what it was like at Bowling Green before this outlandish decision to cage the bull for 6 straight months and place a police car, just to make it more insulting, to place a police car directly in front where you see this area. Now there's a police car. There had been a traffic island. Now it's a police car blocking the view to the bull. It is inconceivable that we are forced to continue to put up with this nonsense. I showed you before Arturo's bull in Shanghai, China. In Shanghai, China, without any barricades, without any police car, without any police in view, you can have a far better experience, far better appreciate and enjoy the bull in Shanghai, as this little kid is right now in this photo, than you can at Bowling Green. This is the charging bull we deserve, and this is why this madness must stop. Now, here we are, back to the sad, sad reality of Bowling Green today. Look at this, the entire plaza barricaded. Look at this, here's a group, typical group of tourists last Saturday. Look at this, they're out here in the street, all right? Rather than up on the plaza, up in the street, trying to get close. Tour groups coming from all over the world. One of the stops they all want to make is to come and see the famous bull. And what is Police Commissioner Kelly forcing them to do? Stand out in the street. Look at the bull through barricades. Stand there while buses, trucks, cars pass by. It doesn't make any sense to me, it doesn't make any sense to you, but this is what we are constantly forced to put up with. Keep looking at it. 6 months now, 6 months now of this craziness. And look at this, this police car on this day parked right up against the barricades, making sure you can't even stand in front of the barricade and get a direct photo. Is anyone going to say that this is necessary? Necessary for what, Commissioner Kelly? Look at this, here's another group. They're not even coming over because, in fact, they don't want to stand in the street, or their tour director doesn't want them to stand in the street. Here is another view of the same situation taking place Saturday, March 15th, 2012 at Bowling Green. It's almost impossible to watch too much of this footage because the more you watch of it, the more it becomes so clear that this should not be happening in New York City, that there is no justification for this kind of treatment. There is no logic to what is one of the reasons, one of the great attractions in our city, both for New Yorkers and for visitors all around the world, being forced to put up with this. Again, 6 months, no end in sight, because there is no decision-making process that allows any of us to effectively challenge this nonsense. And let's return to the issue of police overtime. These officers are being brought in on overtime from precincts all over the city. Again, estimated cost per hour, per cop, $75 total. Between September 17th and this week of March 17th, my estimate is over now $650,000 of taxpayer money. Why aren't these cops out there doing real police work? There are places all over this city that still need better police enforcement, better police visibility. Instead, these two gentlemen are having an interesting conversation, I don't know, about last night's Knicks game, their vacation, their families, how this is going to increase their pension, what kind of great stressless overtime this is. I have no idea exactly what they're talking about, but what I do know and what you do see is all these people standing out in the street with these barricades and with this police car in the way of the bull, while these two officers ignore it. Now, Commissioner Kelly, if we have such a dangerous condition here, why aren't these police officers inside the cage, looking at everyone, taking care? Why are they having casual conversations, basically looking in the other direction, completely ignoring the bull in the crowd? I don't understand that. Maybe you can explain it to all of us. Let's return once again to those photos of what it was really like at Bowling Green at Charging Bull for almost 22 years up until September 17th. You have to keep returning to these images to fully appreciate the difference and to be as upset as everyone should be about what is going on now. This, what you're looking at now, had become one of the great quintessential scenes in New York today, in New York history. Just an unprecedented interest in this great work of sculpture by Arturo de Modica, Italian sculptor Arturo de Modica, now debased by our own city. Now our own city and its police commissioner undermining the appeal, undermining the ability of people to come from all over the world and truly enjoy the statue. Not for a day, not for 2 days. This has been going on for 6 months, and there is no response at all from the police department when this is going to end. None at all. Look at these scenes. You know, those of us who have been here all this time and who have seen and know what it was like and the great joy that it produced, and now I have to put up, look at this wonderful scene that is no longer available. Some of these scenes are from summertime, and that's a good point because the crowds are phenomenal as the weather gets warmer and warmer. We would expect this spring and summer and beginning at the Easter holidays, huge crowds to be coming. They're either not going to come this year because of the barricades, and those who come are going to be crowding the street, making for an even more dangerous condition than even during these colder months. Again, now take a look at what we have going on right now. So this is the sad, pathetic story of what is taking place at Bowling Green in what we call the greatest city on earth, can do no better for this incredible, fantastic creature, this magnificent, larger-than-life work of sculpture by Italian sculptor Arturo de Modica, can do no better than this scene, this terrible scene of the debasing of the undermining of the appeal of this fabulous attraction, and spending hundreds of thousands of dollars of unjustified police overtime. Is this really what we expect in the greatest city on earth? Contrast what I showed you before, Shanghai, China, an official police state. No police car like this up against Arturo's bull in Shanghai. No barricades up. No anything preventing visitors and Chinese people from coming and enjoying the sister bull to this bull, the greatest of them all, Arturo's charging bull. You should be as concerned as I am that we are currently living in a city where this can go on and on and on, and none of us have any ability to stop it. Look at this parent with his two young children. Up until September 17th of last year, of course, he would bring those two kids right up to the bull. They would stand under the bull. They would be amazed. He would take great photos. He might put them up on the shoulders of the bull, and look at what he's left to do now. Stand out in the street behind the barricades. This is the security we need at Bowling Green, and finally have a high-powered police department security camera monitored 24 hours a day from police headquarters by officers who are in a position to dispatch other officers and a police car if there is ever any reason for concern. This is legitimate, logical security for Bowling Green and for Charging Bull, not what is taking place day after day here at Bowling Green now. That big plaza behind Charging Bull is where people should be standing, not worrying about big trucks like the one that just passed hitting them because visitors are forced to stand in the street. To add more insult to this horrible scene, look at these barricades right up against the torso of the bull on both sides. What are they accomplishing? Absolutely nothing. What is the mentality that would cause the police department to just be that much more insulting by taking barricades and putting them right up against the torso so it's even more difficult to even take a halfway decent picture and to further insult the great work of the artist Arturo de Modica? Again, you're looking at something that should not be happening in our city but has been for 6 months now. Here's more. Why would Police Commissioner Kelly undermine the reputation of the New York City Police Department by having cops here in this way, wasting time? The reputation within this area has absolutely deteriorated as a result of this obnoxious activity, forcing highly trained, well-paid police officers rather than going out there and doing real police work, standing around, bored out of their minds, collecting overtime, of course, and having conversations with each other for 8 hours. Is this what our police department really should be doing? Again, we have all the security we need day in and day out with this high-powered police surveillance live monitor camera here at Bowling Green. So all that said, the following day, Sunday, in a banner headline on the front page of the New York Times, deficits push municipalities to despair. Mayor Bloomberg is quoted as saying, in a radio interview on Friday, Mr. Bloomberg noted the spreading financial woes of local government, saying towns and counties across the state are starting to have to make the real choices. Fewer cops, fewer firefighters, slower ambulance response, less teachers in front of the classroom. How can he make this statement and at the same time justify wasting over $500,000 in overtime pay for nothing but to destroy the quality of this neighborhood and our great attraction, Charging Bull?